Hello, my dear friends. Welcome to Fortron Academy. My name is Harshwats, and today I am going to help you in understanding Power BI Service Interface. Power BI Service is an essential service which is used for publishing, assessing, sharing, and collaborating the data that you have created using Power BI Desktop. So, to understand the Power BI Service, we have to open that service in an Internet Explorer. In that case, we are using a Microsoft Edge. So let's go to the Microsoft Edge and see how does this Power BI service works and what are the interface that we could understand using this service. Now we are in Power BI service, and this is how Power BI service landing page look like. This is a landing page which we have signed in. So in my previous video, I have told you how to sign in Power BI service. As I have told you that Power BI service is usually works on an Internet Explorer. That means it's a landing page that you opens up in a Power BI official site. After signing in, you will get into this landing page, and this is how it looks like. So before going into the interface, we will divide to understand the interface in two parts. In the first part, I will tell you about the navigation pane, which is this, and another that is this pane, which is also important to understand. So before going any further, I will tell you that why Power BI service is essential. As you have created the data in Power BI Desktop and generate and make a report out of it. After that, you want to share, publish, collaborate, access your data using the internet. Then you can only use a Power BI service. Then only you will be able to access, share, collaborate, and publish your data anywhere. So let's explore the Power BI service now. So this is a Power BI service logo, first of all. After that, we have a list of Microsoft services just adjacent to a Power BI service. When you click on it, you will see there are a lot of Office 365 services that are available to you. So this doesn't make a lot of sense in here, so we will close it. But you can see that in Power BI service, we want to directly go into the Word, PowerPoint, SharePoint, Yammer. You can directly go from here also, so we will close it. Now let's get back to the navigation pane. So this is a navigation pane. So when I click on a hide the navigation pane button, you will see the navigation panel will be closed and you will see your navigation pane like this. When I again click on it, you will see the navigation. So after getting into a navigation pane, first thing we will see a home page, which is also can be said as a landing page, which you see like this, in which I will see a good afternoon Harsh, in which there's one video that is shown by a Power BI service which you can watch and see how it works. But certainly in this video I will teach you everything, and there are workspaces that you can directly go from here. After that, recommended apps, learn how to use Power BI service, all these are available on your landing page, or you can say a home page. After the home page, there is another service that is favorites. When I click on it, you will see there is nothing that much available in our favorites because we haven't used this service till now. But in my future videos, I will tell you how to create your favorites, which will be shown in your this point after the home button. So after the favorites, we will move into the recent bar. When we click on a recent bar, you will see a page like this. But certainly there are files if you use a Power BI service frequently. But as we have not used our Power BI service, that's why you are not being able to see any files in your recent column. After the recent, we will move into the app section of a navigation pane. When you click on it, you will see something like this, which is usually in the first time because we haven't used any app or made any app yet to create or collection of dashboard or report in one easy to find place. but certainly we haven't used it. That's why we are not getting any apps yet. But don't think of certainly certain apps that you are making, like gaming app or certain social networking app, which we are not creating in here. These are the simple apps that are used for collection of dashboard and reports in one easy to find places, which we have created in our desktop, Power BI desktop. So those are the only apps that we will generate in here. So certainly do not confuse it with gaming app or apps like that. So these are the simple apps that will help you in exploring your, they will help you in exploring your reports and dashboard. Now after apps, we will go into another section in a navigation pane which is shared with me. When you click on it, you will see a service of a Power BI in which we will get any information from an organization that if certain person shares some file with you, you will see that file in this section. You can see when something is shared, you will find it here. That means if you are an organization, or certainly if you are working with certain peoples and you want certain file from them, that can be shared to you through Power BI service, and that file will be shown in here. So in this section you will find that file. After share with me section, there is another section that is learn, that is learning center. That means your hub for all Power BI training. If you want to learn something new in Power BI or something old, because Power BI is a continuously developing software that which currently receive an information from a Microsoft that is currently updating. If you want to learn new and what are coming new things, you can directly look into the learn stuff and see how these things are currently developing. And if you want to attend certain training, you can go here, testimonials, and learn how to use Power BI, dig into documentation, join the Power BI community. You can certainly go into this section and learn from it. After the learning, there is very important point in our navigation pane, that is workspaces. When you click on workspace, you will see the workspaces that one is available to us is Slack, which we have created. That means the workspaces are the things that you use. Like if I want to create my personal workspace in which I work for my personal things, and there is one workspace that is for professional, and you can create so many workspaces for particular work or certainly for another stuff that you can certainly use by making a distinction within them. And the data that within one workspace can be shared with other workspaces and can be different from other workspaces, that is completely dependent on you. In here we only have a one workspace, and if you want to create more workspace, you can click and create a workspace. Certainly we are not going to do that in this video. This will be explored in our upcoming videos. We will close this workspace. After the exploring the workspaces, we will go into my workspace. When you click on it, you will see the get data option. So get data option, you will see like after the getting data in our Power BI desktop, we have explored everything. Now we want to go forward by publishing, assessing, sharing and collaborating our information. For that, we need Power BI service, and for that our My Workspace is available. So certainly these are the things that will help you in discover content, create a new content, and all these things are available to you in My Workspace. So when you click on the expand button from the My Workspace, you will see there are four options: dashboard, reports, workbook, dataset, that is available to you in your workspace. First of all, we will talk about the data sets. As you have told you, the Power BI service works on our data set. Like in my Power BI desktop, I have told you the how we collect our data set, and on the data set we work on and generate the reports. So these are those data sets. And after that, we have a workbook. Certainly workbook are those things like in the Excel, which we have a row information and which we convert into a better data set. So these are the workbooks which we use from Excel. We will explore this dimension into my future videos. After that, we have our report. And report is one of the things we have generated in Power BI desktop. The only thing that remained unexplored through our video till now is dashboard, which we haven't generated till yet. Because what is dashboard? The question arises in your mind. The dashboard are the simple things that in a one page, you will see the epitome of the knowledge of the whole your reports. That means you want a certainly 20-30 reports for everything, but certainly using a dashboard, you will create a one epitome of it. That means every information within those reports will be available in your dashboard, and your dashboard will explore the every dimension of your data set. So till now we have explored the left side of our Power BI service interface, which is the navigation pane. We will close the navigation pane and we will move into the right side of the pane, that is this toolbar. So first in the toolbar we have a notification. So what is something new, or whatever something new in your Power BI service, or certainly any shared information, you will see a notification in here. After that, another important and most crucial thing is settings. So when you click on it, you will see manage personal storage, create content pack, view content pack, admin portal, manage gateway settings, manage embedded codes. Out of all these, manage gateways is one of the most important thing which we will explore in our future videos. So for now, you will see all these things are available in your settings. So we will click on the side of a Power BI service and close the notification. After that, we will have a download option. And if you want to download Power BI desktop, data gateway, paginated report builder, Power BI for mobiles, analyze in Excel updates. So these are the things that you can download from Power BI service. Certainly we are not doing any of them, but data gateway is one of the crucial things we will look into in our future videos. After the download, we have a help and support section, which is certainly most used if you are new to it. You can see the most of the information if you are new to it from the help and support section. You can see how getting started with Power BI documentation, learn, community, get help, Power BI for developers, privacy and cookies, accessibility shortcut, about Power BI. These are all will be available in the help and support section. After the help and support section, we will have a feedback. If you want to submit an idea or an issue, you will submit in your feedback section. After the feedback, we will have a sign out option that is available to us. When you click on it, you will see your email ID and your sign out option. So these are the things that are available to you in a Power BI service. So I hope you have understood the new interface or the Power BI service interface. So this is certainly the old interface that we use. And when I click on new lookup, you will see the Power BI service has been updated and its new look has been upgraded, and Power BI service now look like this. So this is the difference between our old look and the new look. On all the navigation, that is toolbar option, that are available in this side will be moved into this 3-point bar. When you click on it, you will see all those things that are available in our previous look within this side. So there is not much change in the new look, but certainly you should know what are the difference between the old look and the new look. So we will get back into our old look and will tell you how this our Power BI interface works. So I hope you have understood everything from the Power BI interface. And if there is any doubt, you can certainly comment us in our comment section and we will get back to you. Again, for the clearance, we will again go into the new look so you will understand what are the changes that are happening in our Power BI service. And this is much more compact and efficient Power BI service interface. So this is the same interface I have told you. In the right side, in the left side we have a navigation pane, and in the right side we have a toolbar that we have a notification, settings, download, help and support. There is no thing that is removed, just we have much more compact new look. So this is how the new look is and Power BI service. This point I am going to end this video, and I hope your queries got clear, and if not, kindly write us in comment section and we will surely get back to you. And if this video helped you in any way, kindly drop us a like and don't forget to subscribe our channel for amazing videos in future. Till then, have an amazing and good day.